Hello and welcome to LA Noir. Kind of took a break from this game over the weekend, but we are back. I think. I don't know. I already kind of forgot what the hell I was doing. Oh yeah, we had to go to the liquor store after we shot these guys over here. Now I remember. Okay. To the liquor store. Okay. Alright, so we have another dead body, as usual. Now we got another something going on. Alright, see how close it is. Let's see. Where the hell are we? Wait, where are we? Oh my god, I'm completely fucking lost. Where is my car? Let's see, launch the player. Well, we're not here. You'll have to excuse me, I just woke up. Have we ever been over that way before? Was it Hollywood? Leisure. And, Central. Well, it shouldn't help.
We needed to handle code 2, identify.
Oh god, we just trashed that car.
Damn it.
Let's take a look at the map again and see if I can find myself. Ah, here we are. Oh man, that's really far away. Hell with that, no. But anyway, in the last video, we started this case of her dead body. And, we're at the liquor store, so let's just start running into things. We also shot, I think, killed two guys. I can't remember what the hell's going on. Alright, Phelps is getting here to investigate whatever the hell's happening. Because I already forgot.
What can I do for you?
LAPD, Phelps and Galloway. We're making inquiries into the murder of Evelyn Summers.
Evelyn? She's dead?
Yep.
You knew Evelyn Summers, Mr.
Robbins? Yes, I knew Evelyn. I was a good friend of her ex-husband. She kept some of her stuff here.
Can you show us, please?
Sure. Come this way.
Alright, well, this guy's... Well, he's being cooperative, that's good. Let's see, what kind of shit fires does he have?
You got some fine stock here, Mr. Robbins.
No, go around, we're getting police.
No, you let us take some for the road, this case might get solved a lot quicker.
He's joking, Mr. Robbins.
What the hell's this?
She wasn't always such a loner.
Yeah, we got anything with this book, what's this?
Evelyn was reading Aristotle?
Evelyn wasn't stupid. The only stupid thing about her was her need to drink.
Oh, for her to be smart, she'd be counseling, wasting the whole time. Okay. Let's see, we have a bowling pin.
Rawlings Bowling Alley. Maybe Evelyn did something other than drink in her spare time.
Rawlings. I know that place. Corner of 9th and Graham.
Oh.
A lot of cops bowl there on Tuesday nights.
Okay, at least I don't have to call to find an address.
I'm guessing Evelyn hadn't held down a job for quite some time before she was killed.
Yeah, this looks like a trophy.
When exactly did Evelyn work in the pictures?
A few years ago. Worked in legal copyrights for music.
Well, that's like 9 years ago. That's more than a few. I was looking in that corner. We have another picture here. Friend, sister. I guess we're not getting nothing off of that. Got a broken mirror as well. I thought maybe I heard someone else back here. Is there anything else back here in this game? It doesn't look like it. Alright, well, let's talk to him.
We're trying to account for Evelyn's movements yesterday.
She came by in the morning.
A social visit? To pick up some of her things?
She had a couple of bucks and bought a quart of rye.
Any idea where the money came from?
She didn't mention it. But she did say the booze was a present for a boy. She said they had been fighting and she had to make it up to him.
So she had a boyfriend.
Were you and Evelyn close, Mr. Robbins?
Not many people will be sad she's gone. I'll be one of the few.
When Evelyn bought the booze, did she say who she was meeting or where she was going?
A young drinking friend of hers, I think. Don't recall his name.
Oh, shit. Well, alright, let's go head to the bowling alley. Maybe I'll know some more. Oh, shit. Alright, so... bowling alley, we're going to get that one selected here. Alright. Guess I'm going for the intercom? I'm hearing shit. Just hearing shit. Alright, see how far away this is. Oh, that's actually pretty close. Okay, cool. Let's see how many more cars can just drive into this side here. Ugh. Damn, I think I slept for way too long. I'm still really counting for... oh, here's the bowling alley right here. Oh, the entrance though is out there and sad. Just crashing into things like, well, I'm going to load. Alright, see if anybody here knows her.
Hello, Rusty. Two on your usual lane?
I'm Detective Phelps. Homicide.
You must be new. What's your shoe size?
Not eight,
I'm conducting an investigation, ma'am. Do you know the name Evelyn Summers?
Sounds like I should. Oh, maybe it could be Jimmy's friend.
Jimmy?
James Tiernan. He's a pin setter. One day he introduced me to a lady after work. It stuck in my mind because she was much older, too old for him.
Where can we find Jimmy, Florence?
He'll be hopping around the lanes. The back.
Thanks, man.
Like, Phelps, why are you yelling? Is that him back there running around like a madman?
Root beers all around.
Why is he running? I don't think he saw us.
Tiernan! LAPD!
He's running. Jesus Christ, why do you always gotta run? Oh god, oh, Berg, get the car.
There.
Oh no, we'll just steal this one. Oh, this one looks a little sporty.
What are you waiting for? Get out of here!
We just stole this vehicle.
We might go faster if we weren't carrying the extra weight.
And he's got all the booze on him.
These are flashy cars to be parked outside of bowling alley.
Lanes attract a fast-living individual with money to burn.
Or a middle-aged individual with the need to feel virile.
Well, keep it steady and I'll try to bust his tires!
Oh, that didn't. Shit. Sorry.
Why do they always run? I'm sure we've got the wrong person in more than one of these homicides, but they always seem to land it.
No, your theories are not airtight by any means.
What are they talking
about? Don't go to sleep on it. Give me back.
Oh, God, he just crashed that car.
This isn't the killer. We can at least get him for reckless endangering.
That's unless he runs into a wall and saves us all the trouble. Hit it. Clean this asshole off the road.
Oh, damn, I'm knocking something off.
Going through the square.
Oh god, where the fuck is this guy's a madman? Oh Jesus Christ, these people are running.
What if they run because someone's setting them up? Because they feel like the deck is stacked against them.
I don't make up ridiculous stories for them.
Okay, that man, she should have.
Oh, looks like we're going into the tunnels.
God damn it, he'll kill himself.
All right, as long as he doesn't kill us, I'm okay with it. That's the end of that. About fucking time.
All right. Yeah, we done fucked up his car.
Put your hands where I can see them.
Yeah, why? Phil's like, why do they always run? They don't help themselves at all. And this boy's going for, he's going to jail for sure, but don't know exactly for what. Well, not for. Oh, who drove our car over here? That was nice, huh? He is like completely wiped out in that one car. I was trying to get this out of enforcement into that train. That didn't work. Barb is the one murdered me. Oh, he's Barb.
The possible 415 at Alvera Street Plaza, Unit Dan, code 3, identified.
Let's see, how far away is this one? Nah, hell of it. Oh, and there goes the front door. I'm trying to remember if I get that many wrecks on the ramp that bottom as well. It's crazy for him. Someone like me who does as much racing games, how awful I am at actually driving. Like, if you want to race, oh, I'll race you, but you want me driving? Oh, no, I'm going to hit everything out here. Oh crap,
Jesus,
sorry.
No.
Sorry. Like, I wonder if you look at my bill and add up all these cases of all the construction costs, it's gotta be up to tens of thousands of dollars. Up right here. Alright, let's see how this goes.
Drink, fellas. Phelps, Galloway, homicide. We need to ask you some questions concerning Evelyn Summers.
I'm Walter Mensch. Evelyn Summers? What is it now?
She's dead.
New Evelyn?
As well as I wanted to know Evelyn. She's a pain in the ass, always coming in here, cadging drinks, never had any money. She was in just a couple of nights ago.
Did she ever tell you where she was staying?
I don't know. I think she was living rough. She had that kind of stunk about her.
Who did she drink with?
A bunch of these guys. Ask around.
Alright. A bunch of these guys ask around. There's only one dude.
What's your name?
Grosvenor McCaffrey.
Mind if I ask you some questions, Mr. McCaffrey?
I'm just a starving writer, detective. What do you want to ask about?
Evelyn Summers, and why she was found beaten and strangled in the rail depot.
That was kind of pissed right now, ain't he?
Okay. I see your point.
How well did you know her?
I can't say that I knew her. It was more like I was aware of her.
Aware of her, okay.
Did you see Evelyn last night?
No, I was at home, writing.
Bullshit. Now, yeah.
Do you want to get dragged into this, McCaffrey? Do you want us to get interested in you?
She hung out with this powder puff, James Tiernan. They haunted the public library together.
How well do you know James Tiernan?
I know he works some kind of plebeian job at Rawlings Bowling Alley.
Alright, criminal history.
Do you have a criminal record, Mr. McCaffrey?
Nothing serious. I've had a few skirmishes.
Few skirmishes, yeah.
You want to save me some time, or do you want me to look up your file?
Industrial disputes, strikes, workers' rights, that kind of thing.
A regular fifth columnist. Nice to meet you, comrade.
Thank you for the information, Mr. McCaffrey.
Well, that didn't seem like that really got us anywhere. Alright. What now? Let's see. Where's the next place we can fuck around at? See, case objective, blah, blah, blah. Why are we investigating a liquor store? Oh, well, I guess I need to go back up. Maybe I missed something. Alright, I'm back on the road again. Yes, I'm public minutes.
Did you make him McCaffrey?
There'll come a day. It's coming very soon. We'll run him and the rest of his Pico buddies out of Los Angeles.
Amanda's a suspect. Rusty.
Yeah, my partner. He seems like he just hates everybody. At least the bar was closed.
Whoa there!
Or maybe it's not close, I don't know, I'll just tear it. Well I kinda blocked myself in, oops. Oh my god, really?
That's a guy from the papers. Solved that big case.
Yeah, you notice I just wrecked the car right in front of the fucking liquor store. Hang on a second. Back her up. Alright, now we can get in.
See him? Saw his picture in the paper. He worked that case. The lady that was cut up like
a... Yeah, it seems like everyone knows about that damn case.
Hey, that's a pretty girl dressed in that nurse's aid uniform. You know who she looks like?
Is there missing something? Jane Wyman.
You, Miss
Wyman.
Hello, Edgar. Hello, Charlie.
Wait, is that a letter here? No, I can't pick that up. Yeah, it's gonna use a. Hang on, yeah. Because apparently there's someone here I'm missing. Can't find it. Or maybe not. Next, I already looked at this. Nothing else already go off, but. Oh, I didn't open this. Oh, someone.
She was borrowing books from Grosvenor McCaffrey.
See, I already looked at this stuff here. There's something out back. Okay, Phelps, that's it. See here. Yeah, we're at the liquor store now. Is there anything else here? Case objective. Investigate liquor store. Well, that's what we're doing right now. I don't know what else that we're missing. Maybe he knows that guy. Nario, not Nario.
Do you know a friend of Evelyn's by the name of McCaffrey?
Not personally.
We're struggling for leads, Robbins. Did she know McCaffrey?
She idolized him. From what I gather, the feeling was far from mutual.
Ooh, she had a crush on him.
Seems to peddle a revolutionary stance, fixing the ills of society. You can see how
communist too.
Down and out like Evelyn.
Thanks for your help, Mr. Robbins.
No problem. Hey, I'd like to make arrangements for the funeral. You think I could get in touch with Evelyn's mother?
Put in a call to the watch commander at Central Station, Mr. Robbins. He'll be trying to reach the next of kin.
Thanks. Get the guy, huh? Evelyn never hurt anybody.
Alright, it's time to get the hell out of here. Alright, so we're finally done here. Oh my god, fucking Rusty, can you move a little bit quicker? Oh, thank you for, unfucked our car.
Car 11K, Car 11K, Swift. Car 11K, Car 11K,
we're here.
KG HPL.
11 King.
A message from Captain Donnelly. Return to Central. Go to.
11 King, in or out? Let's not keep the man waiting, Phil.
Yes. Oh, shit. That's not make our way over here. I'm starting to get back in the swing of it now. No, I'm a bit more awakened here. Yeah, playing. Oh, maybe I'm not. Crash. Pow. Oh, there's an error pit. There goes someone's front bumper just flying over the place. So I've been thinking about the next game I'm wanting to do. I'm kind of leaning towards a Star Wars game. It should be my third one on this channel. Just kind of unsure which one. I'm thinking of your Star Wars X-Wing Alliance. You know, old flight sim on PC game back in 1999. Or maybe Republic Commando.
I get the point.
So I'm kind of leaning through those two. Oh shit! Ma'am, excuse me. Now I have a better idea once I get closer to the end of this series. Probably sometime in June. Oh god, did I do fucking screens this shit in the workplace?
I think his name is Phelps. I read about him in the newspaper.
Is everyone okay?
The captain is downstairs with Ray Pinker and Carruthers.
I don't remember the layout of this fucking place at all. Where is downstairs? Oh, down here. Why didn't you open up that door
for me? I'm out of here.
See these guys down here? Yep.
What's this about, Captain?
Ray and Mal have some concerns over the Henry and Muller cases, which I don't want aired outside of this room.
Yeah, and we had the wrong
solid,
dude.
Captain?
I agree, Rusty. It's just that corpses keep piling up.
Copycats.
I've been banging the same drum. But the notes and the lipstick messages.
Evelyn Summers, Cartel Classic Carmine. Each woman, same brand, same color.
Teresa Terrelson didn't have a lipstick message.
Technically, you're right, Rusty. She didn't have any lipstick. But she did have a message. We
really?
Found it beneath her dress, scraped with a sharp stick.
What did it say?
You sure you want to know, Ray?
Yep.
As far as we can be sure, it said, cunt BD.
That's one way of looking at it.
Looking at what?
Cunt is all about access, Phelps. You're married, so yours is mortgaged. Some of us like to pay by installments. This guy doesn't like to pay at all.
Why are you so angry, Mal?
Because I just had to fire one of my assistants. He was a friend of Jameson's. God knows what he might have been up to.
Captain, we have good leads in the Summers case, but it's up to you to decide how we proceed.
Keep this under your hat for now. And to follow up on Evelyn Summers, I want daily reports.
So they're starting to question whether or not we're actually...
We got our orders. Back to the Summers case. Get an address from McCaffrey. He'll have blown the bar. I'll meet you outside.
All right, McCaffrey's apartment.
You think those Vice boys get any on the side?
But yeah, Ned... They're starting to question whether or not we've been getting the right guys or not. I've been kind of questioning that for a while because we keep getting the same murder over and over.
Let me pose a question. Penn, what you got to do with it? Morals. Would it bother you to put the wrong person away?
Depends.
On what?
On whether anyone except the poor son of a bitch in the slammer ever found out.
Well, hang on. Let me do this phone call here real quick as we got find out what this guy's address was.
I heard he's an honest cop.
Oh, yes, no, maybe. We're just showing a phone here. It also is over here. You have a phone in here I can use? No? Okay. Oh, over here.
Operator, message for KGPL.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need an address for a Grosvenor McCaffrey.
Grosvenor McCaffrey. Apartment 6, 126 Yale Street, between Ord and Alpine.
Thanks.
Alright, well, we have the apartment now.
What's a five-star goddamn wedding?
I was gonna say, like, why is he, like, just popping one up right next to me? the fuck's that noise? Is that... Alright, let's go and put McCaffrey's apartment down here as a destination. But anyway, we will go ahead and call it a video here. I'd like to thank y'all for watching, and we'll see y'all next time when we head to this guy's apartment and see what the hell is going on. Thank y'all for watching. Peace.